My name is Tom. Welcome to Living Through Limits. Well, today we're going to work on a dishwasher. We found about a week ago that we had a leak on the floor, and we thought maybe something got spilt or something. And so we mopped it up on the floor here. And, well, it happened the next day too. And so I got to doing some kind of preliminary examination and found that the drain hose on the dishwasher was leaking, but I couldn't figure out why. So I took this apart, and I took it apart. We didn't film it, and we have chairs in here and stuff because granddaughter likes to climb into where I had the dishwasher. And so all the area in there was flooded, so we had a fan on it for about a week to help dry it all out. So we pulled out the dishwasher and found that this was leaking. Now the interesting thing is it didn't wear out. If you look right here, there's a big old hole. You know what that hole was caused by? A mouse. It was eaten here too. That was caused by a mouse too. So we had a mouse get into the house somehow. Down where the dishwasher sat under it, there was rat or mouse poop, which is disgusting to think that you have that in your house. So I had to pull the dishwasher out, which is pretty simple. It just has two screws that hold it in on these tabs. Well, I also found when I took it out that this part, this is the fill line. This hooks where your dishwasher water comes in, then there's a hose that comes and hooks in, and this was the water comes in. It kind of works like an air gap, comes into the dishwasher. Well, you can see this white stuff here. It's been seeping. And so I called the local place, appliance sales place that I bought the dishwasher from, and asked them for parts, and they said, oh, we don't carry parts anymore. You have to call this number. So the number is back in, it goes to a place, my parts are here. This, if I can get the invoice out. So the place is you call is back in Chicago, Illinois. And they told me, oh, okay, we got all your parts in Sacramento. We'll send them down to you. So I told her what I needed. I had the part number for this part here. But I didn't have an actual part number for this. And so they have the whole, they can pull up the whole schematic on the dishwasher. And I said, I need the drain hose. So instead of sending me the drain hose, they sent me what's called a hose fill. And it's a tube that hooks to this instead of sending me this. So I had a universal hose. And we're going to see if we can make the universal work. This was $11. This came off of Amazon. The two parts that I bought from this place, this inlet water piece was almost $58 plus tax. The wrong hose they sent me, which is still in the package, was almost $42 plus tax. That's kind of ridiculous for the prices they get. I should have just got a piece of rubber hose. But anyhow, so we're gonna put this dishwasher together, the new part. Doesn't come with a new gasket or anything, so I have to reuse the old one. And we'll see if we can get this dishwasher put back together. When I noticed that the mice had gotten down here, I can't figure out where they came from. So what I'm gonna do, and I can feel a little air coming through. So I'm going to take some caulking, and I just have some old caulk, and I'm going to utilize it, and I'm going to fill a gap back there. Because the other thing I notice is I get this old house. House was built in 1959. I get a lot of draft. So I don't think the guy filled up a lot of holes, because I've filled holes that he's worked on. And so anywhere there's a gap in the plywood, the subfloor, I'm going to fill the gap up with caulking or caulk and just kind of seal it up, keep the varmints out. So what I like to do is take a piece of wire, run it down through here. Looks like it's still pretty good. Okay, when I disconnected my drain hose, this is the drain hose that goes up to the air gap on the dishwasher. Sometimes when you run the garbage disposal, which it hooks to, you can get back through this. So I just found a scrap pin, clamped it in there, kind of made a temporary plug just in case. Didn't want another flood. So now we're going to see if this drain hose and that drain hose are compatible. Take the clamp off, maybe. I think, yeah, we can make that work. Put the knife away, and I shouldn't have. So I think what we're gonna do, there's on these drain lines, they make them for several different sizes. So you got 5/8, 7/8, and 1 inch. And so it kind of gives you a cut line to get each side. So I'm just going to cut the 1 inch off so I can get further on there. And hopefully my knife is sharp enough to get through that. And if you look down in there, you can see that it's bigger here, smaller there. So we'll see how far this part goes in. Goes past, starts on the 7/8. See if we can get this hose to modify onto the dishwasher. Down here is your motor, your pump, all that. So the pump, this is the discharge. This is where that hose was that was broken. So we're going to see if this hose fits on here, which hopefully it will. Okay, looks like we have it. We'll run it through where it goes. We'll get our spring clamp. Things are a little hard to... get that. This is where our other part that went bad was hooked up. Now the hose, they sent us a new hose and I paid for it. So I think what we'll do is we're going to replace that hose too. Here, this is where the water feed goes into the dishwasher. It's really hard to see. But this is kind of, this is how to have the electric solenoid that turns water on and off, and then it runs through this black hose up onto that other part, and that's what fills the dishwasher. So we're going to reach under here, undo another clamp, kind of blindly. We'll take this hose off. And I'll get my other parts. I think I got to sharpen my knife. They always say a dull knife's worse than a sharp knife. Okay, now that part. New drain hose. Put them on here. This is interesting because this is like an air gap. This water on this thing, I don't know if you can see in there, the water comes in this nozzle here. There is nothing. If that got plugged up, you're going to flood out here and you're going to flood all over the floor. So we're going to put that down where it belongs. There we go. So that's a new piece. And I forgot to get my gasket. Put the flap up. Okay. See, what this thing has too is kind of a natural, what would you call it? Like an air gap. So that drain line comes up the side of the, comes out of the discharge, comes up. And this, the way it's made, is supposed to clamp. The original hose was big, small enough that it clamped right into here. Well, we're going to have an issue with that because this hose is too big for that. I'm kind of modifying it. So we're going to go ahead and go down through here like the old one. But what I'm going to do once I'm on here, I'm going to zip tie it to the different areas. Didn't even come with a new nut. You spend $58 and they send you this piece of plastic. Didn't come with a new nut, no new washer, nothing. So we're gonna put this into place here. We're gonna zip tie that. Reach in here. And just use our pliers and just snug. We don't want to break the nut. Okay, so that's done. Then we take our other clamp off here. Old hose. New hose. Take our clamp down. Ouch. And stick it on there. We can bend that one out a little bit. That one holds, that one holds. That gets our air gap back. We're gonna grab a couple of zip ties. Now, as you can see, we've got our, coming back up on our loop. Everything looks good. Nothing looks in the way. We'll run our hose back through the bottom of the dishwasher. One thing that happened when the guy that helped remodel my house back when I first got sick is he did something that bent the bracket that holds the front cover on this dishwasher. This has been sitting up here for a few years. This is the front cover. I saved my parts, but we're gonna see this here. This got bent because the guy was not careful. If we square that up, we're way off over there, and likewise. So we're gonna grab the pliers, because I tried to bend it back before. And hopefully I don't break something. And it looks like we gotta go a little bit further, because only one side is bent, and he bent it pretty good when he did this. And it looks like with a little finagling, I can get that cover back on. Okay. And the cover goes on after the dishwasher is in place. We push the cord back in through the hole. Now we're gonna push the dishwasher into the hole, and hopefully we won't have to adjust too much here. The nice thing about these dishwashers, this is a nice dishwasher. This is a KitchenAid. This dishwasher has wheels on the back side, and so I only have to lift the front a little bit, and then I can kind of just kind of tuck things in. And once it goes off, the wheels go off the wood, and then we can kind of tuck the insulation in, hopefully. Everything's going back in like it should. And I just laid on my keys. Okay, when I took this thing apart, I had to lower the front because of the way they put this together. Okay, I got my little torpedo level. And so what I want to do is, as you, I don't know if you can see that on camera, but the bubble is way off. And so I had to adjust it when I took it apart to get it out. And so now we're gonna adjust it back in. Okay, and then I can take this under here, and I'm pretty good that way too. It has two screws up in here that hold this. And what those screws really do, one, they hold your dishwasher in place, but also when you have your door down, there's a lot of weight there, and this dishwasher could tip. And so it's a lot of a safety factor. Especially if you have little kids that like to climb on things. Okay, now this discharge hose is longer than our original one. So, we're gonna have to kinda move things back and forth a little bit. Not kink it or break it or any of that. And you don't want to over tighten it because you don't want to break anything. So we got that. And now we'll see. And one thing with all my, you got to find a comfortable spot. Because as with the name, living through limits, we got body issues and my bones hurt. And if I lay on my ribs too long, they really hurt. Kind of put this back where it's going to be. Now what we want to do is we want to test this dishwasher out. First thing we're going to do is we're going to turn the water back on and make sure our inlet doesn't have a leak. These clips only go in one way. You push them in and then you have a screwdriver and you turn it and it spreads out the little ears here. So you push that in there, hold that down, get your screwdriver, turn it a quarter of a turn. I want to thank you for watching this video, Living Through Limits. Please hit the subscribe button, thumbs up, and leave any comments and any suggestions for future videos. And I hope you have a good day, and we'll talk to you later. Bye.
I don't want to set the world on fire.